So now that we know how to work with multiple right-hand sides when performing Gauss-Jordan elimination, what we're going to do is we're going to set the right-hand sides to the identity. The reason for this is that if we're trying to compute the matrix X such that A times X is equal to the identity, we know that if we do that, then X becomes the inverse of A. And we know that if we partition the identity by columns, then A times the columns of X must be the columns of the identity. And therefore, in order to compute the jth column of the inverse, what you want to do is solve with the jth column of the identity. And therefore, if we append A with the unit basis vectors, and then perform the algorithm that we described for working with multiple right-hand sides at the same time, then we know we end up computing the inverse of the matrix. So here's the idea. If you have multiple instances of the equations but with different right-hand sides, which are now the unit basis vectors, then we can append those to our matrix, and then we can just do Gauss-Jordan elimination with that, and we would expect the right-hand side to be overwritten with the inverse. And how do we do that? Well, we do that like we always do it. We compute the Gauss transform, we apply it, we update. And one thing interesting to note is that in the first step, if you do a block matrix-matrix multiplication, notice that this times that is this, and the Gauss transform times the right-hand side is this, and therefore you know that the right-hand side just becomes that Gauss transform. And notice that everything to the left of what I just drew actually needs to be updated, but is updated with the first column of the Gauss transform, and the rest doesn't even change. That can save you some computation. Then if we move forward, we compute another Gauss transform. We apply that to this matrix. But notice that now this right here will pick out the second column right there. So we expect this column to simply be that column right there. And the rest of the matrix here gets updated. Of course, these zeros were already introduced, so it's really this part that gets updated. And this column of the identity is left alone. So then we move forward, and we do that one more time. We again notice that this is just this column right here. And we are now left with a diagonal matrix here. And if we then take that diagonal matrix, invert it, and multiply, what we end up with is the identity here and the inverse of the original matrix right there. And if you multiply the original matrix times the inverse, you better get the identity. So the general principle is that we've proceeded to a point where we have introduced zeros there. We now would like to introduce zeros in this column right here. For that, we compute multipliers right here. We apply that, and then when we apply it, we introduce a new column here. We introduce zeros there and there, and some kind of update happens to these columns of A and the right-hand side. Describing this more generally, here is the state that we're in. This is the diagonal matrix that has been created so far already. This is the part of the identity matrix that has not yet been touched. We compute multipliers. We multiply those out. Notice that we compute the multipliers in an effort to introduce zeros here and here. We notice that the next column is simply the current column of the Gauss transform, where all the action is. Some other updates happen right here, and if you look carefully, it's yet again a rank one update, updating each of these parts of A and B. And this is what you get. If you then want to work that into an algorithm, that looks like this, and you're just going to have to carefully look at this maybe in the notes, but this is where all the action is. And then we have to do a sweep where you go through and you multiply the current row of B, which of course will hold the inverse eventually, by dividing by alpha 1 1, and then you set that alpha 1 to 1 so that this matrix eventually becomes the identity matrix. And now what we have is a variant of Gauss-Jordan elimination that computes the inverse of a matrix.